So as you guys know, I've been trying to get an African butterfly fish for the flag tank, and today I finally got one. I actually went to the pet store, not looking for one in particular, and they just happened to have one. So there he is right there. I'm going to talk really quietly so I don't spook him, but that is him right there. I've been letting him acclimate for a good 15, 20 minutes now, so I'm about to put him into the tank. But you know what I decided to do? Actually leave the hood off this tank. There was no light anyways. I'm not going to put a light on this tank because I want it to be just all natural sunlight. I don't want it to be any really bright light in the tank, so that light's going to be, you know, good enough, the outside sunlight. And yeah, at night I'll just put the hood back on so I don't worry about him jumping out or nothing. But I want to come out here in the daytime so I can actually like look over the top of it and see him from above, because they're really made to be seen from above. You can see the two pectoral fins right there, and that's where they get the name butterfly fish from, because it looks like, you know, butterfly wings. But yeah, that guy's acclimating. This is going to be the only fish in here. They don't really need that much room, you know. They don't do a whole lot of swimming or all that, but it's going to be pretty dang cool to come out here and see this guy from above and watch this guy eat, because they're pretty darn cool eaters. Now, they're actually related to arowanas. Actually, you can see the similar body type and all that. They like to hang at the top of the water, but they don't get nowhere near as big, and they don't do, you know, a whole lot of swimming either like arowanas do. You know, arowanas are like constantly swimming. These guys just kind of sit around the tank, but yeah, still pretty dang cool fish. But like I said, he's gonna be the only thing in here. And you guys know I've been wanting to get a peacock bass, you know, a medium-sized one or something like that for the pool pond out there with the Marlboro car in it. Well, I told you guys in the last video that I might just put a baby peacock bass in here, since they're a lot easier to get at that size, and then I could just raise them up in this tank and then, you know, put them out there, because I wouldn't want to put, you know, an itty-bitty baby peacock bass out there in the, you know, the big 300-gallon pool pond. So I can raise them up here, get them a few inches, and then move them out there. Well, I went ahead and got this guy, but I still might do that. If I end up doing that, of course, I'll just take this butterfly fish out. I have several other tanks that I can put this guy in, and of course, I can just put the peacock in here. But for now, this is going to be the fish we have in here, and it's going to be a pretty darn cool little fish. Adrian Castro got the fish picture in last video, correct? This is the fish picture for this video. Be the first one to comment down below the correct name of that fish. If your comment's pinned, then you're going to shout out in the next video. All right, so I got him right here, being really gentle with him. And there he is. Oh my gosh, look at that dude. Dude, he looks so good in here. He looks so cool from above. I don't want to spook him, but look at that guy. He looks so good in here. And by the way, if you're wondering why I wanted a butterfly fish in here, it was so, since, you know, they kind of hang it out the top and stuff like that, so I didn't have to put any type of like structure down here at the bottom. And that's why I wanted the butterfly fish in here, because obviously they stay at the top and won't really need nothing on the bottom, because I wanted to have the flag, you know, fully open to sea like that. But there he is right there. It's a little bit of a glare, but that dude looks great with outside sunlight. Like I said, I'm just going to leave it like this during the daytime, and then at night I'll put the hood back on. But dude, he looks so good in here. All right, I'm going to let him settle in. I don't want to freak him out too much, and I'm going to come back in a few minutes or so and go and check on him then. These fish are looking great, even without no light and with just, you know, the natural sunlight. Still looking for a light for this tank. If I don't find one, like I said, I'll just have to get one of the 10-gallon Acuon LED lights, and they do pretty good, actually. It would just have a little bit of excess on the side, but all the fish there are looking great. So I got to add some water to this tank, but the African cichlids are looking great. I think next weekend we're going to go ahead and pick up a few more cichlids for it. These guys have been here for a few weeks now. They've been doing great, eating a lot and all that. So I think we're going to go pick up a few more. Like maybe try to get try to get two of everything. So like maybe get another Snow White if I could find one. Definitely get another Dragon Blood. We have two OBs. Try to get another Sunshine and maybe another Albino. But yeah, we're going to try to have two of everything in here, and also probably get like some lemon cichlids as well. And I talked a little bit about this in the last video, you know, the Kerbensis. I thought they had spawned and all that because they had dug out that big crater down there up underneath that rock, and I thought I saw some eggs down there. The female was going in and out, the male was kind of guarding it, so I was like, you know what, we've already got some spawning going on. I haven't even had these guys that long, but unfortunately, the eggs are no longer in here, and there's no babies. The female's not going in and out anymore. So what I think happened is that they actually ate the babies, unfortunately, which is something that, you know, a lot of fish would do, especially like cichlids and stuff. But yeah, we'll see if we get any more, you know, breeding action out of these guys anytime soon. So it's now actually the next day. The butterfly fish has been doing great. I actually had a little bit of water to the tank. He's actually hiding right up there right now. up underneath the filter, like right behind it. But he either stays right back there or right out in the current. But yeah, he's been doing great. Oh, there he is. He's coming out some, and he's starting to get more used to me. He's not quite as skittish as he was yesterday, but just look at him from above. Dude, he looks so good in here. And just wait till he actually starts getting more used to me. They're not the most personable fish, but they can kind of, you know, get really used to you and all that once you start feeding them and all that. So these guys can eat a variety of things. They have a wide range of things they like to eat. So yeah, it's gonna be pretty cool feeding this guy and watching him eat and all that. So yeah, I'm gonna try to start getting this guy to eat and all that, and hopefully sometime within the next few videos or so I can get this guy to eat on camera. But yeah, there he is for now. I actually did a water change on this tank earlier today. I'm sure you guys can't really tell much of a difference because, well, there's no actual like main light on the tank. But yep, all the fish are happy and healthy. Also added some water to the cichlid tank. So I know you guys can tell the difference on the Jack Dempsey's tank. I actually did a water change on his tank earlier today as well. And obviously you can tell a pretty big difference because it actually has a light on the tank. But got all the algae off the glass, and yeah, his tank is looking great. And he's doing great as well. So I didn't do a water change on the convict's tank today, but I actually did scrape the algae off the glass of the LED, what it's like sitting on right now. So yeah, if you notice your tank light is getting dimmer, just all you gotta do is just, you know, take the glass off and just kinda, you know, scrape the algae off of it. But yeah, it is looking back bright. So we're gonna feed the cichlids right now. We're gonna drop some of these little pellets in here. And I've been feeding them two different types of pellets, actually. These pellets right here for like all different types of, you know, fish and stuff like that. And then some strictly cichlid pellets. But these are a little bit smaller, and these are the wide range of fish pellets, I guess you'd say. But they definitely love them, and what they don't eat, the Cynodontus comes out and just gets everything that gets down to the bottom. So yeah, and the plecos start coming behind as well. But I do drop a few of the little veggie pellets in here for those guys. So look at them go. They just go ham on these little bitty pellets. But thanks to the Cynodontus down here coming out, we're gonna get one or two more of these little dudes. But you know what's funny? This Cynodontus catfish actually came from Walmart. Yeah, my grandma actually picked him up there one night, and this is actually the third one I've had there from Walmart, and every single one of them just seems to do really, really well and grow really fast as well. But yeah, we're gonna get one or two more of these guys, but probably not from Walmart, probably like the pet store or something like that. I don't know. Dude, look at the albino. Look at that guy. Now, like I was talking about yesterday, we're gonna try to get two of everything in here. The only thing we actually have two of is the OBs right there. There's one of them right there, and of course the plecos, but we actually have three of those guys. But we're gonna get one or two more of the Cynodontuses, and also get a few more cichlids in here. And I think this tank will be pretty much complete. Go ahead and get some pellets of these guys right here. We'll look at them. And actually, when I was doing a water change on this earlier today, and I had my arm in there, mainly the red-eyed tetras, also some other little tetras in here, but mainly the red-eyed tetras. So even phone, oh. Yeah, there's one of them right there. So those guys, they were actually nipping at my arm. It was mainly those guys, but also the other tetras were doing it as well. But look at those guys. And all them little pellets I just put in there are gone. Gone, every single one of them. Also did a water change on this tank earlier today. As you can see, it's back looking really well. It's a tad bit, just a tad bit still cloudy because I put a little bit of Kent here to make it like look really crystal clear. But other than that, all the fish are looking great. You can see them really active, especially the filamentosa barbs, one of the parrots coming up, the Congo. But see the dojo down there. But yeah, they're all doing great. Pretty soon we're gonna be getting some more angelfish for this, and they're actually gonna be, you know, big angelfish. Check out the Lupe cichlids. They're starting to get really used to me now. There's one of them right there. I think that's the one that's a little bit bigger. Now, this guy actually still has a little bit of, like, black on him still. But the other guy, the little bit smaller one, is, like, pure yellow. And you can see him right up there. And like I said, they've been getting really used to me now. That one's a little bit more dominant right there, that bigger one. But, yeah, they've been getting along pretty well, I'd say. And they haven't been bothering the quarry cats at all. But, yep, they are looking great and doing great in this tank. Look at the female beta right there. The neons, this tank's looking great. This driftwood is actually still releasing a few tannins in the water, so I'm doing weekly water changes on like 50%, and it's slowly but surely I'm starting to get, you know, the tank looking crystal clear, but it's a little bit cloudy. Look at a little pea puffer right there. Look at him. I'm still gonna get one more in here. I know I keep saying it, but I still am gonna get one more little pea puffer in here. But There he is right there, and he's the only thing in here except for some little zebra snails. Here's the pool pond right here. We're going to be getting a new fish for this pretty soon, probably an albino Oscar. I don't know, we'll just have to see, and then of course a peacock and maybe even a gar as well. But yeah, we're going to get a new fish for this pretty darn soon. That is pretty much it for now. We finally got an African butterfly fish for the flag tank. Now, it is going to take him, you know, a few days, maybe a week or so, to really get used to the tank and get used to me walking under the tank where he doesn't like spook and stuff like that, and hopefully he'll be out swimming a lot more and all that. But well, certainly when he does start eating and all that, I will film it. If you guys have any video ideas for me, comment them down below. I would definitely be open to reading all of them and maybe even doing your idea. Be sure to drop a like on the video, hit that subscribe button if you're new to the channel. With that being said, you guys, we'll catch you on the next video. Peace.